So Kazuha is here and he has one thing that no other character in Genshin Impact has. Why does his full name on the screen? Yo, Exnel here and this is my Kazuha guide. Kazuha is another amazing sub DPS character who you can use in virtually any team comp. He is also one of the few enablers of a single element team, like a triple pyro plus Kazuha team, as he gives elemental damage bonus to the whole party according to the element he swirled. His crowd control is not as good as Venti or Sucrose, but he makes up for that in damage and a very, very fun playstyle. He is not viable as a main DPS unless C6, so if that's what you're looking for, then I suggest you hold on to your Primo Gems. There are two things that are important to know when you are building him. One is, even though he is going to be a sub DPS, you must max him to level 90 as swirl damage scales with level and elemental mastery, and this scaling has been buffed big time. Number two is that even though he's a sub DPS, you will still want to level up his normal attack because plunge attack scales with normal attack talent, and you will be doing plunge attack with Kazuha whenever you do his elemental skill. We'll cover the two ways to build Kazuha in this video, which are either a triple EM, support machine, or a sub DPS, just like any other sub DPS. I just want to give a big shout out to Chorong for providing this account. Do check him out on Facebook, he live streams if you want to see his Kazuha in action. So Kazuha's basic mechanics, his elemental skill looks like this. He does a jump, and then you can do a plunge attack. When he does the jump, he does pull enemies in, and then when he does the plunge attack, he also does pull enemies in a little bit. If you hold E, he takes a while to charge, and then you can also plunge attack after it. If you do it while there is an element surrounding you, then you will also deal additional elemental damage according to the element you swirled when you jump, like so. And that is a hydro plunge attack. Most of the time, you will want to hold E as it doesn't take too long to charge and does more damage and a larger AoE. His burst is basically a huge swirl machine. It's not as big as Ganyu's ult, but it is big enough to cover much of the fight. And as you can see, it does swirl from time to time, so just go ham with all of the elements that you can find. Do take note that with any swirl reaction, especially with an AoE as huge as this, there is a priority when it comes to elements being swirled. The priority is Pyro first, then Electro, then Hydro, then Cryo. So keep this in mind when creating your team comps. Now for the talent priority, you will want to prioritize his burst, and then his skill, and then his normal attack. As I said before, it is still worth upgrading his normal attack as he will be doing plunge attacks, which scale with the normal attack talent whenever you use his skill. This passive talent, we covered this earlier, if you jump and you swirled something on the way up, you will be doing additional elemental damage according to that element on the way down. Now this one is interesting, and this is what makes Kazuha very good in a pure pyro team comp or pure electro team comp, is that he will give elemental damage bonus to the whole party depending on what he swirled, and that swirl can come from his skill or his burst, it does not matter. So that's 0.4% elemental damage bonus for every point of elemental mastery. At this current build, which is 865 elemental mastery, this would give the party 34.6% elemental damage bonus. Now put this on top of the minus 40% elemental resistance decrease from Viridescent Venerer, and that's
a lot of damage
for the weapons. Now, as I said, there are two builds, the triple EM machine or the sub DPS build. For the triple EM machine, the easiest recommendation is the Iron Sting, as it gives a lot of elemental mastery and is craftable. But if you're going for a sub DPS build, then any of the DPS swords like Black Sword or Blacklift, if you're looking for more crit stats, are good. Lion's Roar is great for a pure pyro or pure electro team comp. Other options are Ally Flash and Harbinger of Dawn. If looking for more burst uptime, then Favonius, Sacrificial, and Festering Desire are all good options. For artifacts, in both builds, you will be using a 4-piece Viridescent Venerer. This is just way too good to pass up on an animal character, except Xiao. For the triple EM build, as you would expect, triple EM on Sands, Goblet, and Circlet. I know this will be hard to farm, so you could settle with not having triple EM at first and then just keep building onto it gradually as you play the game. For the sub DPS build, which is basically the same as any other sub DPS build, you go attack percent on Sands, elemental damage bonus or animal damage bonus on the goblet, and crit rate or crit damage on the circlet, depending on what you're missing. Again, you want to maintain a crit rate to crit damage ratio of 1:2 while still maintaining a high attack value as well. As for which build is better, is it the triple EM or the sub DPS build? Just think about whether you're able to maximize Kazuha's high elemental mastery by doing a lot of swirls and the elemental damage bonus he gives to the party due to his passive. Then you can go EM build. But if you already have a really good team, a really solid synergistic team, and are just looking for more damage with style, then sub DPS is fine. So enjoy this Canadian ether, and see you on the live streams on fb.gg/xnoph. You can also join our Discord. We have 8,000 members. You can party up, find people to hang out with, ask questions. Just get in the Discord. All right, and I'll see you around.
Teamwork is dreamwork. Blood of frost.
Oh no, no super friend. Wrong rotation.